Hi guys, it's Minx here. Welcome back to Gabriel Knight, Sins of the Father. Thank you everyone who's been watching so far. It's really awesome of you. I'm glad you'll continue to join me on these adventures. It's going to be an ongoing thing doing these lengthy point-and-click adventure story-driven stuff on the channel, so if you have any recommendations of games you'd like me to cover, please feel free to recommend them in the comments section. But just so you know, there are some adventure games on the channel already, so please search the channel first to make sure I haven't covered them, if you can. And you may even find a Let's Play you really enjoy. So anyway, we need to talk to Madame Canazo, and we need to establish her phone number. And I did a little bit of research, and there's the phone, but how am I going to find them? Let's go and look at the thing anyway. There we go. So, oh, okay, we have a bit of paper with it on. So there are a few Canazos here. We got, let's try the second one.
Hi, Casanow residence.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me.
Yeah?
A woman in the Dixieland drugstore dropped her purse today, and the name Casanow was inside it.
Dixieland drugstore. Never heard of it. Sorry.
Okay, well, I guess it's not that one. We'll get there in the end, guys.
Hello?
Hello, I'm calling from the Dixieland drugstore. We have an order for you.
Castro, be quiet.
This is the right person.
I'm a friend of the owner.
I'm sure I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, well, she's got a dog called Castro, so we call Cajun Critters Veterinary, and we say who we are and why.
Cajun Critters Animal Clinic, this is Melissa.
Hi, Melissa. Madame Casino.
Do you have a Madame Casino as a client?
Madame Casino? Sure, I know her. She's not here right now, though.
Really? She told me she'd be there. Would you happen to have her address?
If they give me the address, that's bullshit.
Yes, but I'm not sure I should give it out. Who are you again?
I'm worried about Castro.
I'm worried about Castro. He's missed 3 dance lessons.
Castro? Her little doggy? Oh, he's so sweet. Well, I guess if you know Castro, it's okay. Her address is 345 Dauphine.
Thanks.
And that's how you stalk someone, boys and girls. Okay, I guess we, gonna be heading out into the world, I guess. Or should we? Or what else? We had other stuff to do. Stalking 101, see? Well, that's funny. All the funny achievements. We had other stuff to do as well. I'm pretty sure the cop said we could come and see an interrogation as well. So let's go and do that first. I'm actually this Castro's face. Let's go. I want to see the interrogation first. There's a guy playing a drum outside. Good for him, I guess. Mostly. We stole your badge. Really fucking hope you don't hold that against us.
Can I bother you again, officer?
What is it this time?
Well, you were in the Wolf Among Us. Mostly.
I'm here to see Detective Mosley.
He's in his office. Go on back.
Okay, off we go to see Detective Mosley. He's probably worked out by now that we took his shit, if I'm honest with you, so...
You!
Yeah!
Give me back my badge! Now, Knight!
Sure. Thanks for letting me, borrow it.
Yeah? You borrow it again, in your history. Now, about today. Glad you made it. It'll give you a feel for how I am in action. You know, handling suspects, that sort
You're
of
such
thing.
A dick.
I'm sure it'll be invigorating. Who is this guy, anyway?
Calls himself Crash. He's been an informant for us before, mostly helping us bust small-time pimps and dealers trying to break into the territory.
Okay.
He's been staying invisible during these murders, but we picked him up this morning at Jackson Square pushing coke. He knows something. Call it detective's
Why would he know
instinct.
Something?
Detective's instinct. Got it.
Hi, Crash, with your weird hair. How you doing?
All right, Crash. I want to hear about these murders. Have you been present at the so-called voodoo rituals?
I don't know nothing. All right, I told you.
Come on now. You can tell me. Do you know anyone who's been to these rituals?
Oh, so you crash, huh?
I can't say nothing. You gotta let me
go. Put us with a fucking murderer, is you prick!
No one knows you're here. The men who picked you up were in plain clothes.
Sorry, go ahead,
plain clothes? Like you could fool them. They know I'm here. They've got ears all over the city. They know everything.
Who are they, Crash? Are they the ones doing the murders?
Let me go.
If you're so worried about being detained, start talking. You tell me what I want to hear, and maybe I can get you into the witness protection program. But you gotta earn it.
Witness protection? Are you crazy? Oh, don't make me laugh. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, just let me out of here.
Oh, come on. Who's behind these murders, Crash? Why are the victims all members of
the
Underworld?
Oh, that's me.
Oh, by now they know I'm here. It's different when I'm supposed to come here. Oh, if I can send a message. Yeah, tell him I didn't say nothing.
Christ, he's freaking useless. Just take him back to detaining, would you tell
me? Yeah, that was a pretty unhelpful interview, to be honest with you. Presumably I need to find something to make him talk.
I tell you, times like this, I'd kill for truth serum. Damn civil rights.
Can I quote you on that?
Huh? Hell no. Damn, we can only keep him for 24 hours. Tomorrow morning, I'm gonna have to let him go. Sorry it wasn't more exciting. You know, for the book, I mean. Hey, maybe you could punch it up some. You know, what do they call that? Fiction. That's it.
It certainly is. I'll see what I can do.
Okay, so is that the only reason? Well, I'm gonna go. Okay, so we gotta find something to make that guy talk. Let's go to the park and pick up our art, hopefully. Oh, when it says, go back. Hi, Mr. Addis. How you doing?
How's it going today?
What? Oh,
only me, yeah.
I have been jumpy all day. That pattern of yours really freaked me out for some reason. There's just something creepy.
You finished it?
Yeah, and you're welcome to it. Here.
Wow. This is great.
Uh-huh, yeah. Just don't, like, blow up the planet.
I'll try not to.
Okay?
I didn't mean to upset you.
Ah, forget it. I'm probably just being stupid. Do your thing with it, and, good luck.
Well, you are new, so let's talk to you. Who on earth is this?
Madam Lorelei, is it?
What can I do for you, handsome?
I don't really know. I guess, how's business?
How's business?
How's business? I have no time for such dull conversation, darling.
Nice snake.
That's a nice snake you have there.
Oh, I could say the same.
Oh, Jesus, really?
Well, I know where I got mine. Where'd you get yours?
That's personal.
Is it an anaconda? About the snake.
I'd really like to know more about that snake.
Oh, sorry, sweetie, but I don't discuss Elvis with anyone.
Okay, so it's called Elvis. How about a reading?
How about a reading?
The prices are listed on the sign.
They seem a little steep.
Well, I sometimes do my intimate friends for nothing, but I am a businesswoman.
I'm sure you are.
Okay, I guess we're going.
Nothing.
Well, then move aside, sweetie, but stay where I can look at you, okay?
Okay! Well, business is gonna be hot for her, I guess. Anything else around here that's relevant? Ooh, what the fuck? What did I just click on? She's doing something. She's doing something!
Come on, boys! Hoopla!
Okay.
I'm looking.
Gabriel leers at the dancer, but she seems to want a more overt demonstration of his appreciation.
Okay,
not a bad idea.
Okay, we're gonna grope her, I guess?
Baby, I love
you. Oh my god, really?
Madame Lorelei winks knowingly at Gabriel.
It's like an embarrassing voiceover by your nan.
Yep, she wants me.
Oh, God. Oh, what's she got there? Well, I'm not in control right now. Oh, she's dropped some. Okay, that's probably relevant, I'm guessing.
Thanks, boys.
Let's grab this, I guess. That's an easy way of getting a crucial item, I'm guessing. What's this? Hello. What do we have here?
The veil belongs to the fortune teller. It's covered with shiny, iridescent sequins.
Like the one we found on the beach?
Gabriel examines the veil with the magnifying
glass. Oh, there's a scale.
The fortune teller's veil is studded with sequins. The sequins look a little strange. Why? It's a snake scale.
Oh yeah, it was a snake scale we found on the beach, wasn't it? Not anything else.
Gabriel carefully uses the tweezers to remove the snake scale from the veil.
Fantastic news! Right, so can we combine stuff now, can't we? So, how do I combine again?
The iridescent scale is hued olive green. It doesn't seem to match the scale from Lake Pontchartrain.
Okay, so it's a different scale. I guess she's innocent. Will she give me a free dance now that we are best buddies? Oh no, we'll give her the veil back. Shit.
Madam Lo-
What can I-
Did you lose your veil?
I think this veil belongs to you.
Oh, my veil! I'm always losing those things.
You just drop out my vagina all the time.
Well, darling, you're such a sweetie to return a lady's delicates and so handsome as well.
Well, I-
And since you have such a clear interest in fortune telling, let me see your hands. They look so strong. Perhaps they will make both our fortunes clear, no?
I wish something would.
Have a look. Tell me something good.
Strong.
Shut
yes,
up!
And yet so delicate and flexible.
You don't know that.
Oh my god, he's so cheesy.
Oh good. I see a mysterious woman in your immediate
Is that
future.
You?
Madam Lorelei winks
it's
at
you.
Gabriel knowingly.
She is a dangerous one, dark and beautiful. Oh, I see the road of your life forking, and very soon.
Oh god, something bad's gonna happen.
The blood drains from Madame Lorelei's face in an instant. Sweat beads on her upper.
And weird style comes from nowhere.
Are you okay?
There are forces.
Oh, what the fuck?
Oh god, beware, beware.
Okay. See you later!
What is it about me lately?
Well, that went one down well. Well done, Gabe. 10 out of 10. Okay, so off camera, I did a little bit looking around, and I had to read the newspaper back in my bookstore to unlock this location, Tulane University. There's a talk going on there at the moment that's relevant to the investigation, so we're going there to
it
check
it
out.
It looks like the lecture is just starting.
Voodoo awesome. Is the tribal religion of Africa, but the name Voodoon is actually a banner heading, under which resides an entire body of distinct tribal belief systems. The word Voodoon may sound familiar to you. What is known in the States as Voodoo is actually an amalgamation of African religious systems, Voodoon, and European religions, primarily Catholicism. All
Lovely.
Of these subcults of African Voodoon have certain things in common.
They're all bikes.
The most important is the worship of a pantheon of spirits instead of the single deity that the Christian and Muslim systems have. Some of these spirits are elementals. Some relate to specific tasks or places. Some represent important tribal leaders who have died. This spirit worship is what makes Voodoon so easily adaptable. With all these spirits, it's no problem to add a few more. Say, for example, the Virgin Mary. At the height of tribal Africa, warfare was common. One tribe would conquer another, and the Loa, important in the conqueror's tribal system, would be adopted readily into the conquered tribe's Loa pantheon. In this way, many of the Voodoo cults spread and mingled throughout tribal Africa, enriching the belief system and causing innumerable offshoots. The basis for the Voodoo religion seems to be as old as man.
It's one angry bull.
It has much in common with many early pagan practices. Animal totems, sympathetic magic, elemental spirits in the trees, the heavens, the bodies of the sick. Africa is believed by many to be the cradle of the human race. Some of the Voodoo Loa may be as old as the Garden of Eden itself. We still can't explain some of the real power of these primal religions. And note, I said primal, not primitive. There are African Bokors who baffle our scientists with their supernatural powers. Now, let's discuss the elements of Voodoo.
Okay.
Fascinating guy.
Yeah, he is a bit tedious, isn't he?
The spirits are called the Loa. During a Voodoo ceremony, celebrants are possessed by the Loa. This is called being ridden. The human worshipper is seen as a horse, and the Loa as the divine horseman.
Lovely.
The person being ridden by a Loa takes on the characteristics of that spirit and becomes, in effect, merely a vessel for the more powerful entity. Some of the older original Africa Loa include Dambala, the great serpent god, Ezuli, the mistress of love, Papa Nebo, or Gede, the lord of death, Awe, the spirit of water, Legba, spirit of the crossroads, and the cruelest and most dangerous, Ogun Badagri, the lord of destruction.
I gotta get more sleep at night.
Tribe-specific Loa can have as
much or more
power as the more widely worshipped Loa. For instance, a particular tribe might revere highly the Loa of an ancestor who was a legendary hunter or politician.
I hope this is relevant, because I'm losing interest.
Their priests, Haungan or Bokors, their priestesses, Mama Loa. In a Voodoo Haungfor, there's a ritual circle marked by a center pole called a Poto Metan. During ritual conclaves, initiates dance under
the supervision of a Bokor. Oh, it's one of the things. It's a thing we have.
A Mama Loa or head priestess.
It's a thing.
The use of
totems, it's a thing.
Animal masks and markings was not uncommon in the original African ceremonies. Now, though, all but the oldest sects have abandoned.
It's gonna be an old sect doing this shit here, I'll tell you that now, dude.
During the conclaves, included the ritual gourd, or asan, the ritual knife, or kubasa.
That knife gives me the chills.
The ritual whip, or fuetkash.
Okay.
And the ritual coffin, or seke madule. These
Lovely.
Items are often optional. Called for by the Mama Loa for specific magical rituals.
I assume this is all going to be
Mama Loa
what we need to find?
The most powerful figure in any Voodoo sect. Voodoo is a truly matriarchal system. Even the Bokor knows his power is limited. The Mama Loa is the supreme woman. She goes out of her house at night, sees many things.
What the fuck's going on?
Butterflies.
What? What's she talking
and
weird?
At night again, she sees
what?
Things.
What's am I having a stroke? What the hell is happening? Oh, falling asleep's bad, Gabriel, because you're gonna yeah.
Firelight.
Oh shit me.
Gabriel?
Oh god.
What? Can't see.
Oh god.
Get in.
Can't.
I'm not getting in a fucking oh.
Get in, Gabriel.
Oh god.
Too small.
Oh god, that's gross!
Hide!
Okay! Definitely don't want that dream again!
Let me out! Help!
We've been buried alive.
Young man, the lecture is over.
Oh.
Oh my god. Okay. Sorry.
Wonderful. Well, we made ourselves like a total dick then, didn't we? Guess we should talk to him and probably apologize. Sorry, fell asleep in your lecture, Mr. Man.
Are you a student?
No. My name is Knight. Gabriel Knight.
Well, you've already interrupted and slept through my lecture, Mr. Knight. I hope you have something worthwhile to do here. If you figure it out, let me know.
To be fair, he has a right to be butthurt. We kind of pissed him off.
Do you know what Capri Sankor means?
Capri Sankor? Yes, I do. It's a
That's what that guy said.
Term, I believe. It's French. And literally translates as goat without horns.
Okay.
As in a female goat?
No. As in a human sacrifice.
Okay!
Sacrifices in Voodoo are usually of the animal variety. Chickens, bulls, goats. If the gods demand a goat without horns, it means a human being.
Well, that's pretty fucked up. Yeah, that is important, I feel. Look at the thing!
Can you tell me anything about this?
Wow. Interesting. Very interesting. Mind if I copy this?
Be my guest.
Great. I'll be right back.
Okay, so that obviously is extremely relevant. Let's show him the murder victim as well.
This is a fascinating Veve. You must tell me all about its origin.
Actually, I was hoping you'd tell me. Can you figure out anything about it from the symbols?
Well, some. That's why I wanted a copy. I want to research the design myself.
Have you heard of the voodoo murders?
No. You're kidding. Really? Then the voodoo is authentic. The newspapers are wrong. Boy, are they wrong.
You think this Veve is authentic?
Authentic? Mr. Knight, that's like asking if the Mona Lisa is a painting. Tell you what, I'll look into these symbols myself and see what I can learn about the sect that made
Yeah, you better do that, Scrub.
I'll give you a call when I have more information. You are associated with the police, aren't you?
Absolutely. But I'm undercover. You can contact me at St. George's Bookshop in the quarter.
All right. Now, I'd like to get started on this, if you don't mind.
Okay, that's great, but have a look at this as well. This. Hope he doesn't freak out too much.
Is there anything you can tell me about the voodoo aspects of this photograph?
Wonder how well he's going to deal with that.
This is a serious voodoo ritual. Nasty stuff.
In what way?
Let's see.
Well, the dead body, obviously, that's pretty nasty.
Photograph, except for the corpse, of course. But the wound, the face, and what little I can see of the ritual paraphernalia, It reminds me of certain black voodoo practices. Very rare. I've never witnessed them myself, you understand.
Really?
I was about to have to arrest you. Okay, well that was relevant too. I think that's all we should show. Anything else there? Nah, I think that's all right. I guess we should head off and find more things to do.